Bakro, vas smijem nešto pitat? Jeste li vi zadnja baka koja je u Lubenicama?
Da.
Eto, vidite, čuo sam za vas. This is probably going to be the smallest street you're ever going to see, and it's about 5 kilometers long. So bear with me. Oh, look at this. Dobro jutro. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of feel claustrophobic here. And here we are, Lubenice. And I want to show you something here directly on the parking. Wait a second. Good morning, Croatia. Let's go. So this is kind of the main entrance. And here there was a stone wall that was made during the Roman rule. But it was torn down later on. So there's not much left from the stone walls. But yeah, this is how it kind of looks like. And that's the main entrance to the village. And there we have the first church, the bell tower, and a coffee place. But the interesting thing about this place is, although it has only one old grandma that's still living here, it has 5 churches already at the entrance. So church one, tower, church two. So we're gonna find all the 5 churches. That's our main task today. Dobro jutro. A settlement was first mentioned here approximately 4,000 years ago, and it was still, you know, like the Bronze Age and the Metal Age. But the first ethnic group it was mentioned to live here were actually old Illyrians and a special group called the Liburns, and they were doing mostly, you know, like sheep. They were holding sheep, they would be fishermen, and they would also be pirates. The Liburns, so the ethnic Illyrian group that lived here, was actually assimilated. So then begins the Romanization of this, you know, like ethnic group, and they're becoming more and more Roman. And Lubenice, which is today's name of this small village, was actually Hibernice before that. Ah, look, small restaurant. Maybe I can go on a coffee later on. We're going to the highest point in the village, up there, and then we're going to see the view. Before we go to the mountaintop, I want to show you why this place was so important strategically. It's because of the mainland, and there is actually an entrance to the big cities on the mainland coast. So the Liburns, and later on the Romans, and later on the Italians, the Croats, and so on, they were actually fighting for this island pretty much, because from this position, from this high position, you could use it as, what is it called in English, like a scouting position, and you could identify, you know, like ships that are way, way, way up, and then you can alarm the whole, you know, like island chain and the mainland cities that enemy ships are coming. And as I said, the Liburns, they were actually also pirates. So just imagine you're having ships down there somewhere in the beautiful beaches, and you see some, I don't know, Italian or Roman ship down there floating around without any garrison, and then you just send out your ships, you know, like, and plunder it. But with Roman rule, that was, you know, like, that eliminated, you know, like the Liburns or the Liburn piracies, the Liburns were actually just continuing to be, you know, like fishermen and only to be shepherds and so on. So they weren't pirates anymore, as the Romans came and brought their Pax Romana in the, I think it was the 2nd century BC. Someone is always already on the top.
Island.
We are still searching for the other three churches, so bear with me. As I told you, there is only one grandma still living here. Maybe we're gonna find her too, but they have 5 churches and approximately 40 buildings. Dobar dan. Bako, vas smiješ pitat? Jeste li vi zadnja baka koja je u Lubenicama? Eto, vidite, čuo sam za vas i vi ste onda zadnja ovdje. Da. Ne idete nigdje.
Ja sam bila cijelu zimu sama tu.
Da? Pa imate nekog da vam pomaže, sin, čer?
Da, ima djecu, onda mi donesu hranu i drva, vidite, sve mi pripremiju. Ali imam i telefon, i struju, i sve, ništa mi ne treba.
Ništa?
I onda, šta, meni je dobro. Ja sam se tu rodila i mi je tu lijepo. Ja imam 86 godina. I tu je mene lijepo.
Je, znate koliko je star ovaj grad? 4000 godina.
E, vidite.
E?
I onda, a mladi su svi otišli na okolo, a neka redu.
Da.
Neka idu, šaka koji...
Pa koliko je prije bilo ljudi ovdje?
Bilo je prije 200 ljudi i više.
Mada.
A da.
Taman sam razmišljao hoću li vas naći ili ne. Jeo, nađe vas. Eto, sve najbolje. Hvala, Dženja. A very nice old lady. So she is the last person who's still living in Lubenice. I have luck today. No, it's not open. No, they're not. Oh, snap. Someone's backyard. That was probably private property, so I'm out of there. It's kind of sad to see, you know, like how much life here was, and now everything's abandoned. Kitty. Meats, doji? Oh, let's see what's up there. Evo, bako, ja opet naišao negdje. Negdje izlazim, ulazim, ne znam jesam u nečijem dvorištu ili nisam. Pa da. Samo skrenem, odjednom sam kod nekog u bašći. The small chapel is open. Oh, and there's the museum. So let's see what they have in the museum. Museum, here we come. So those are the two main roads. that we may, and the grandma is living here. And this is the front church, and this is the church bell thingy. Oh, disinfection. Wait. Dobar dan.
Dobrodošli.
Jel otvoreno?
Dobrodošli, slobodno uđite. Ova zgrada je nekoć bila župni dvor. Davno je tu živio svećenik, koji je naravno otišao kad više nije bilo ljudi u selu.
Pitanje, je li istina samo da jedna baka živi u ovom selu?
Istina je, samo jedna bakica, teta Marija ju zovemo.
I told you so.
Meh. To je tradicionalni instrument i u biti sličan je škotskim bagpipe.
To je znači tradicionalni instrument ove regije.
Tako je. I to se razlikuje s otoka na otok, ovisi o tim rupicama. Vuna je najbolji izolator za ljudsko tijelo, žene su nosile takve halje i po zimi i po ljeti. Na ovim panoima vidjet ćete malo te stare tradicionalne ovoga nošnje, koje evo, ovaj gospodin iz Orleca i on je jedan od glavnih ovoga svirača meha. Ja sam lutkarica iz Zagreba i ja radim vunene maske. Doduše, evo, druga žena, Doris, ona radi vunene lustere. Među nama je glavna vunarica koja se zove Vesna Ljakić i ona ima svoju udrugu Ruta. Od tih 4000 godina koliko su ljudi živjeli u Lubenicama, znači prvi doseljenici su bili dio Ilira, Liburni, pa do naravno Rimljani, postoje rimski putovi, pa Mlečani, Napoleon, svi su se oni nekako bavili ovdje poljoprivredom i stočarstvom. Nažalost, evo, došlo je doba kad u selu živi jedna baka, svi su ili u Cresu ili u Rijeci, ali postoji ta jedna pozitivna priča. Znači, pojavljuje se trend vani među mladim obiteljima iz Austrije, Njemačke, Italije, koji u biti sele iz gradova, odlaze na selo jer žele da njihova djeca rastu u boljem okruženju, da jedu domaću hranu što raste na njihovoj zemlji. I ja se nadam da će taj trend doći u Hrvatskoj.
Nadam se ja. E, hvala vam puno. Okay, I found the third church. And that one is called Sveti Jakov, Heiliger Jakob, Saint Jacob. So it's here. I'm not going to show you the last one. That's the fifth church. But there are only ruins left now. So, yeah, kind of sad. But I know where all the five churches are, although there are only 40 houses here and one old grandma. Okay, I hope that you enjoyed the ride and the visit to Lubenice and that you got a little bit of the Croatian Dalmatian spirit. So yeah, until the next video.
And here we go again.